In this session, I'll be going to explain trapped diode. So trapped diode is trapped plasma avalanche trigger transient mode diode. So here in this diode, we are dealing with two trapped plasma, and then we'll be triggering that with plasma avalanche trigger. So basically, in this complete session, I'll be going to discuss with this session outline where basics of trapped diode, that is what the first case that I will be going to discuss about, and then after I'll be explaining internal structure of trapped diode, and then at the end we'll be observing what is the principle of operation in this trapped diode. So these are the basic things which is what I'll be going to discuss about. Now let us move on to the first session outline, that is what are the basics which is there with trapped diode. So when we discuss about the basics of trapped diode, so trapped diode that has been made up to design it with high frequency operation. So basically we use trapped diode in microwave and frequency of operation that is there in 1-3 gigahertz. So frequency of operation ranges in between 1-3 gigahertz when we use trapped diode. Now some basic performance parameter that we need to consider, like noise figure that is there in the range of 60 dB. So noise figure that is quite high, and that is there in the range of 60 dB. Basically basic advantage of trapped diode is it works at low power dissipation. So trapped diode that is having basic advantage, that is it works with low power dissipation. Now what are the basic things which is there in trapped diode? Basically it works based on plasma avalanche trigger transient, and which has been utilized in microwave. So trapped diode that is working based on plasma avalanche trigger, it works based on plasma avalanche trigger. So that's why we use trapped diode in microwave. The reason is it is having very less recovery time, so we can use that in the vicinity of 1-3 gigahertz. Typically it is having RF efficiency which is ranging in between 0.2 to 60%. So it has DC to RF efficiency between 0.2 to 60%. So it gives very good efficiency when it is there with RF efficiency. When we talk about internal structure, so at that time it is having basically three layers. It could be P plus N, N plus, it could be N plus P, P plus. So it is there with different structure. It is available with P plus N, N plus structure, or we will be observing it is available with N plus P, P plus structure. So these are the basic things which is there with this. Now if we talk about trapped diode, then we use that with avalanche multiplication, where we give current pulse to it, and based on its current pulse it is getting triggered with a storage of plasma inside. So when we give current pulse to that, there will be a trapping of plasma, and avalanche multiplication is resulting into extreme charge carrier generation, and then we release plasma. So we will be observing that in operation principle when I will be discussing principal operation of trap diode. Trap diode is giving much higher efficiency than impact diode. So when we compare this trap diode with impact diode, trapped diode provides higher efficiency than impact diode, but when we talk about noise level, the noise level in trap diode is far greater than impact diode. So we can say it is having higher noise figure, but it has higher level noise figure. So as initially I have discussed, like it is having noise figure that is there in the range of 60 dB. As if we see what is there with impact diode, then impact diode is having noise figure that is there in the range of 20 dB. So that is how it is having higher noise figure. Now let us move on to internal structure which is there with trap diode. So when we talk about internal structure of trap diode, so at that time there could be two configuration as initially I have explained. So it is available with different sets of internal structure category, like it could be available with P plus N, N plus structure, it could be available with N, P, P, N plus P, P plus structure. So here one category of structure that I have shown where we can observe, it is available with P plus N, N plus structure. If we see this structure, then here N type material is sandwiched in between P plus and N plus. So here P type material is highly doped than this N type layer, where width of N type layer that is greater than this P plus and N plus, as well as doping concentration is lower. So here basically we are generating plasma, and where charges are getting drifted, so this is even called as drift space region. So this is how internal structure is there, where low doped material is sandwiched in between two highly doped material. So in second case we can say, like, see, it is there with N plus P, P plus structure. So in that case, that P region which is having higher width, and where we will be observing, like, see, charges are getting drifted, and where we are actually trapping plasma. So two things are happening: we are storing plasma as well as we are drifting charges inside. So let us try to understand how it works. So basically, if we work with this trap diode, then in that what we do is, like, we give current pulse to that. So here we are connecting source, where this source is generating current pulse, and that current pulse will be given to this trap diode, and because of this current pulse there will be a generation of plasma, there will be an extraction of plasma, and those things are happening in sequence. So that we will be studying in principle of operation with waveforms, so that we can understand exactly what is happening inside. So here, to explain principle of operation, I have connected that trap diode with forward bias, where I am giving current pulse to that. And when I give current pulse to that, initially if I start from point A, here point A is there, where if I start from point A, initially there will be a diode which is acting like a capacitor and it is getting charge up to point B. So when we talk about this characteristic, there will be a charging operation. Charging operation, and in that charging operation there will be charging of that drift space region, where current density will increase as per J is equals to ES into dE by dt. So this is how current density increases during charging. So in this A to B region, it is acting like a capacitor. Now next is, once it charges to its threshold value, there will be a initiation of forming of plasma. So plasma is extremely high energy which is there with charges, so that is initiated and that will get stored in the region of drift space. So from B to C there will be a formation of plasma, and if plasma is getting formed, electric field will start to decrease. So if electric field is decreasing, potential will start to decrease. So during that phase, like we can say, this is the space where from B to C there will be a formation of plasma. So in this region there will be a formation of plasma. So once it starts to form plasma, highly energized charges, these are generated in that drift space, and during that electric field will start to decrease, which is resulting into reduction in potential. And after C point there will be a generation of highly dense charge particle. So because of that there will be a dense charges which is there in the region of drift space. So here this is the region of drift space where there will be extremely dense charges that will get formed. Initially from A to B it will act as a capacitor, so voltage will start to increase across this, and then after there will be a formation of plasma. So during that period, here in this region there will be a formation of plasma in this. So what happens is, like, because of formation of plasma, electric field will start to decrease gradually, and then after there will be a dense charge particle, that is what getting stored in this space. So further there will be a reduction of electric field. So after point C there will be a creation of dense charge particle. So up to point D there will be a creation of dense charge particles. So ultimately, see, from C to D there will be a dense charge particle that will be there in drift space region, and once it reaches to lower limit there will be initiation of extraction of plasma which is getting stored inside, which is extremely highly energized charge particle. So ultimately after point D there will be a start of plasma extraction. So from point D to point E there will be extraction of plasma. So plasma extraction is getting begin after point D. So now what happens is, like, from this drift space region plasma is getting extracted and now it will get released. And after removal of plasma, there will be a residual extraction of charged particle. The reason is charged particles are heavily energized because of plasma extraction, which is getting extracted up to E point. But even there will be a dense charge particle, so that will get even released by that residual extraction, and it will start to form removal of charges which is there inside. So here there will be a beginning of removal of charge particle up to point F. So here there will be a residual extraction. Now when residual extraction is happening, at that time what happens is like holes which is there in this drift space region, that will start to move in this direction, and electrons which are there in this drift space region, that will move in this direction. So electrons that will move in this direction and holes that will move in this direction. So that is what residual extraction which is happening inside. Plasma extraction, that is very different thing, where highly energized charged particle that will get drifted. But in residual extraction, dense charged particle that will start to move. So that motion that is happening as per holes are moving in this direction and electrons are moving in this direction. And after that, it will act as a capacitor. So again, there will be a start of charging. So it charges up to this point. Let us say this is point G. So here it acts like charger. So it acts like capacitor. So there will be again charging process. And once that completed, it will be reaching to this point where it will stay flat. And again, characteristic will begin from point A. So that is how this complete process is happening, where formation of charge plasma is happening, and that is what we are trapping in drift space. So that's why trapping of plasma is happening, that's why it is called as trapped plasma avalanche transient mode diagram. Now here few more things that we need to focus about. Here plasma is getting formed, in parallel with that there will be a formation of dense charged particle. So the plasma generation that happens during the region of B2C, and extraction of plasma that is happening in the space of D2E. But removal of dense particle that happens in E2F, and generation of dense particle that happens in between C2D. So from B2D there will be a reduction in electric field, and once it is getting removed, you will be observing potential is getting increased. And when entire process is happening, we will be observing like whatever pulse which is what we have given, current pulse is being given to trigger it. So what happens is like there will be a 90 degree phase which is there during this process in between voltage and current. So current pulse is input in this. Current pulse is input in this. But the process which is happening to form plasma and extraction of plasma, and once it is getting removed, in that this complete process there will be a 90 degree phase with voltage. So 90 degree phase with voltage that will get observed during this current pulse response to the trap diode. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any query, please comment it below so that I can solve out those problem. And if you like my channel, please subscribe. I have placed so many videos regarding diode as well as microwave. So complete series that you can learn it from here. Thank you so much for watching.